shrink straws.
Shrink to drink.
So, this is the team.
I'm Vishesh.
I'm Rick. And, this is the problem.
A huge problem for customers when they go to a restaurant is that their straws are either too long or too short for their drink. Many times, the straw is not the right size, and this negatively impacts their experience. In addition, 43% of the world's plastic ends up in landfills, and 23% of it ends up in the ocean, which can negatively affect sea life.
Americans throw away 500 million straws a day. To put this into perspective, that is enough to circle the Earth 2 times and enough to fill 125 school buses. What if there was a way to eliminate some of that waste? That comes in the form of a metal straw, specifically stainless steel. But no, this is not just any normal metal straw. This is a straw that expands to fit the customer's personal requirements of what the perfect straw height is. So, whether you're worried about the environment or you just get annoyed by short straws, there's shrink straws for you, and you can adjust your straws to the height you want. It's reusable and made of stainless steel, making it much better for the environment.
Okay, this is one of our target customers. This is Garrett Bunter, owner of Garrett's Grill. And because he owns a restaurant with reusable cups, he obviously wants reusable straws. Restaurants spend a lot of money annually on buying straws. However, with a one-time purchase of shrink straws, they can get reusable straws that they can use all the time without having to buy more at any time. Also, with shrink straws, it makes the straw the correct size for anyone drinking from the in his restaurant, which increases customer satisfaction.
This is Felicia Trainer, and she's an environmentalist, so she cares a lot about the earth. She says that she has gotten up and left many restaurants because of serving plastic straws that were bad for the environment.
This is our product, the shrink straw. And the way it works is that it expands in the same way that an extendable pen does. One straw size is the default. It has a wedge you can unscrew to expand the straw and to the size you want. These straws are great for drinking in any size bottles because they can simply be expanded to the correct size.
So this is a little table of our competition. The main competitors of the shrink straw are the extendable plastic straw companies and the Last Straw. The Last Straw makes reusable metal straws that can collapse into a box. However, our straws are better because they actually can use the collapsing feature and still be able to drink from the cup. With the Last Straw, the collapse feature makes it impossible to drink from. Extendable plastic straw companies have straws with the same functions as ours, however, their straws hurt the environment and are not reusable.
Okay, this is the market size of our reusable metal straws. So 500 million plastic straws are used daily by Americans. There's a population of 320 million people in America. Studies have shown that 1 out of 4 people care about the environment. So therefore, our estimated market size is 80 million people because that is one-fourth of the people in America. And people that are care about the environment will want to use plastic or metal straws that are reusable and eco-friendly. Our product, shrink straws, will be sold at a price of $10.50 for a pack of 8 on webstrongstore.com or shrinkstraws.com. And ordering soon will give a complimentary straw cleaner to avoid the straw becoming dirty.
So this is our financial business model and the restaurants that we could actually tap into the market of. There are 331,469 independent US restaurants, which means that they're not a chain. And inside those, there's 58,540 California independent restaurants, and there are 18,231 of those in the Bay Area alone. Now, 8,000 of those, 8,000 of those are already in San Francisco. So, left in the Santa Clara County, there are around 1,270-ish, and over here, you have there are 181 Palo Alto restaurants, which gives, if we want to tap into at least 20% of this market, we can start off with 36 Palo Alto independent restaurants that we can reach out to and give our shrink straws to. So if that does stay at a steady pace in 2019, where we stay at 36, we'll be making $56,700 in revenue. But if we do decide to go to more Palo Alto restaurants, we can make upwards of $70,000. Thank you.
Thank you.